In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to make amazing thumbnails for your videos on YouTube for absolutely free, and it only takes a few minutes to make them. Yo, what's going on, peeps? Welcome back once again to another video. And today I'm going to be teaching you how to make good thumbnails for your videos on YouTube for absolutely free with a website called Pixlr. Now, Pixlr is a similar version of Photoshop, but it's very easy to use and it's free as well. And I'm going to be going over the steps very, very carefully. Now, keep in mind, to have custom made thumbnails on your videos, you have to verify your channel. And that's very easy to do. Basically, click on your photo and then click on Create a Studio, and then go to Channel and then Status and Features. And there will be a little button there, and then verify your channel. Very easy. So starting right off the bat, you want to go ahead and go to pixlr.com. The link to this website will be down below in the description. Basically, click on that link and you'll be navigated to this website. But once you're on Pixlr, you want to go ahead and scroll down until you see this, the Pixlr editor, and you want to click on Launch Web App right here, and it's going to load. And then you want to click on Create a New Image and click on this plus. And then you want to put in the resolution settings. So you want to add the width to about 1920 and the height you want to add to 1080. And you want to check the transparent box and click on OK. So once you've put in the resolution settings and opened up a page, you want to go ahead and put in a background, you know, in your thumbnail. Now, I've just chosen a random casual thumbnail background. The link to this image will be down below in the description, along with some other thumbnail backgrounds and grunge backgrounds and so on. But once you've found a decent background that you want to use in your thumbnail, you want to go ahead and save it to your desktop. So go to the image, right click and click on Save As, and then add it to like thumbnail background 123 and click on save, and then, you know, go back into Pixlr, and once you're here again, you want to go up to file, click on open image or just control O, and then you want to, you know, select the image that we just saved. So click on it and click on open, and it will open up a new window. Now, basically what you want to do is to click on control A and then control C. So first click on the photo and then click on control A and control C. And then close this down, click on this X and do not save it, and go back to the thumbnail page and click on Control V to paste it in. And once you've done that, you can see that it doesn't fit the whole frame. So to make it fit the whole frame, you want to go and, you know, select the layer and then go up to edit right here, and then go to free transform, and then it will, you know, select it, and you want to hold shift, go to the edges right here, and then, you know, increase the size. So increase until it fits the frame, and then click on enter. So once you're done with adjusting the size, you want to go ahead and put in some text. Now remember, I'm only showing you the basics. I'm only demonstrating the basics in this video, and I do not exactly know how you want to design your thumbnail. But as I said, let's go ahead and put in some text now. So click on this A right here, the text tool, and then click on the image, and then add something like, you know, just add your text. I'm going to add my gaming, and underneath that, I'm going to add video. So yeah, and you can, you know, select the text, click control A to select it, and then go down to the font if you want to change your font. So I'm just going to, you know, change this font to All There Will Be a Patch if you want to use that font. The link to it will be down below in the description. And to adjust the size, you want to go ahead and select the text again, and you want to go down to size and, you know, adjust the size. And, you know, the style, bold, what you want to have it. And the color, I'm going to add to white. So basically, you can, you know, change the color right here in the circle. And then in the square, you can select it. So if I want to have green, for instance, I can, you know, choose green. And in the square, I'm just going to drag it to green. But in this case, I'm going to use white and click on OK, and then OK again. Now, if the size of the text is still not big enough, you can go ahead and you can right click on it and click on rasterize. And then you can go up to edit and click on free transform, as we did with the image. And you can hold shift and increase the size a little bit. Now, remember, you have to hold shift. Otherwise, this will happen. And we don't want that to happen, do we? But basically, go ahead and add some text. As you can see, I've just added my gaming, the text layer, and I've increased the size. I'm just gonna add some more text and I'll be right back. So there you go. I've now put in all my desired text layers, and what I want to do is to add some cool effects on them. As you can see, it looks pretty boring. You can barely see the text. So I'm just gonna go to one of the text layers. So my gaming, for instance, right here, right click on the layer, click on layer styles, and then go to drop shadow. And as you can see, it adds a cool drop shadow on the text. So I'm just gonna click on that and adjust it a little bit. So I'm just gonna add the size to about, let's see here, 42. Yeah, 42. And go to outer glow as well. And, you know, this is totally optional. You don't have to do this, but I'm just gonna, you know, spice up the thumbnail a little bit. And I'm just gonna add this to the size 6. I'm just gonna reduce the opacity a little bit to about 29. That will do the work. And I'm gonna click on OK. So once I am done with doing it on one text layer, I can easily copy that layer style by right clicking on the layer I just added and clicking on copy layer style, and going to the remaining and right clicking on them and clicking on paste. and the last one paste. So as you can see, it looks much, much better now. But to make it look even better, you can go ahead and you can add a gradient effect. So go ahead first and create a new layer right here. Click on this beside the trash can and make sure that layer is underneath your thumbnail, you know, background. And after that, you want to go ahead and select the gradient tool right here. And then just click on gradient to select the gradient that you want. I recommend the marine blue, I guess. And basically go up to one of the corners, hold, and then drag it down to the other corner and let go. So once you've done that, you want to go ahead and you want to select the thumbnail background layer right here. So click on that layer and click on this one right here. That will open up the opacity setting, and you want to reduce the opacity like that. And as you can see, it looks much, much better. So now we're technically done with the thumbnail, and to spice it up a little bit more, we can add a gaming controller since this is a gaming video, as you can see my gaming video on YouTube. So basically go ahead and find like a good image. Like, this is a gaming video, so I found, you know, a gaming controller. I'll leave some links down below in the description if you're, you know, making a gaming thumbnail yourself. But once you found the gaming controller or whatever that you're looking for, you want to go ahead and save it to your desktop. So right click, click on save as, and then, you know, save it to your desktop. So gaming controller PNG, and click on save after that. And once you've done that, you want to go ahead and go back into Pixlr right here. And once you've saved it and you're back into Pixlr, you want to go ahead and put in the picture. So click on file up here and click on open image. And after that, you want to go ahead and select the controller. And after that, it will open up in a new window. So control A and control C, and then close this down and do not save it. And once you're here again, control V. And once you've pasted in the picture, you want to go ahead and increase the size so it fits. So select the layer first and go up to edit right here, and then click on free transform, hold shift, go to the edges and increase the size so it fits. And after you're done with that, you want to go ahead and click on enter. So to save your created thumbnail, simply go up to file right here and click on save, or just control S, and change the format to JPG or PNG. Now remember, if you're going to have JPG, make sure you have the quality at 100, but I normally have PNG. And you want to name it to my thumbnail or something like that, because, you know, it's easier when you're going to pick, you know, select your thumbnail to put it for the video. And you want to click on OK and then just click on save. And you've successfully saved your created thumbnail to your desktop. And the last and final step is to go into YouTube and select it and put it in for the right video. And after that, we're basically done. So if you want to add some more additional stuff, you can go ahead and do that. Now remember, your thumbnail doesn't have to look like this, like a thumbnail background and some text and a gaming controller or something like that. In this video, I just taught you the basics so you got an insight of how it is done. And you can basically make your own thumbnail with another background and some other text. And keep in mind, it's your thumbnail, it's your channel, and you decide. But anyways guys, thanks for watching. If you thought this tutorial was efficient and helped you out, go ahead and hit that like button. Also subscribe, that will mean a lot. And once you've subscribed, don't forget to enable post notifications by clicking on the bell beside the subscribe button and checking post notifications so you get notified whenever I post a new video. And with that being said, thank you so much for watching once again, and I'll see you next time.